Buddy, it's Kentucat here, and welcome to another video. Today we are in Fallout 4 End Sanctuary, building a home for one of my settlers. And as you can see, I am using mods, because it says it at the bottom. But all the mods I use are on PlayStation 4, so they should be available for both Xbox and PC, so no worries there. I also hope the video isn't going too fast, but I wanted to speed it up so you don't see the hour-long struggle. Yeah, this clip was an hour before it was sped up. So anyway, I place the foundations in because the wall obviously wasn't working, but the foundations aren't lined up, so I line it up and the foundations are in, great. So I go to put the walls on and I do struggle with the walls, so I have to remove the hedge, place the walls and place the hedge back, but I have some trouble with the front side, which I will get to later. And placing these hedges, they're supposed to be touching the ground, but they don't seem to want to. And that's clipping for the wall, which I don't notice at the time, but I will fix, and I'm just checking here if they're clipping. And it is floating. I will fix it all later. Anyway, I go back to the walls, and this is where my trouble starts. I can't seem to have the doorway on the front, and it's annoying me, and it won't clip. So what I did is I got outer cap doors, and I placed it in the middle and tried to fit a normal wall on, but it still wouldn't work. So I turned both of it into outer cap doors and put a half shack wall in the doorway where there's supposed to be a door, which worked really well. For the roof, I first go to the wrong section, but I place the roof in and it is wrong, but I don't notice it at the time. So I place the roof in and everything seems fine, and then I go outside and I notice. So it goes in and I think, oh yeah, this is fine, perfect, and I try to snap floors to the bottom, but it doesn't seem to want to, so it's all fine anyway. So I move on outside and place another door cap and place a door on both sides, which appear to snap perfectly, so there's no error there and no faulty placing. So that worked really well, and I'm just looking for other types of doors that we have. So I go out the front and I go around the back to place the generator with conduits on the lining, but not on the front side, because on the sides is all we need. So then this is where I realise, so I make the roof flat, which doesn't look too good, but it means I can place stuff on the top of the roof, which I do later. So the conduits are going around the sides, stopping at the sides, and I try to manufacture the wires for the thing, but I end up just putting the wire on the very corner, and that's how it works. So I go to place the lights in, hoping the conduits spread full apart, and this is where I discover my swapper. So I get my light bulbs and I start placing them, and they're all good until that side, which means I need to place more conduits on this side, which isn't too much work. I've got tons of materials anyway because I use mods, so it should be fine. All the lights are lit up, so now I'm getting walls and placing them in to make a little wall divider, so it's not all just one big room. And I'm trying to figure out the layout, which I eventually do, and I find this internal wall, which doesn't snap, but it's like a doorway section, a doorway cap thing, so I use it. And then I realise settlers don't like it. I realised this because a settler came in while I was building and annoyed the crap out of me. Anyway, so I get my bed and I'm just scrolling for all the beds to see which one would work best. I try the bunk bed and it doesn't want to fit in, so I go back for the single bed eventually. I'm still trying the bunk bed, but then I realise, let's just go all the way back to start and use a default single bed. So I put the bed in and I'm trying to align it perfectly, and I try to put a pillow on the top, but it doesn't seem to want to go, so I leave that after struggling a bit more. Alright, this is the settler I was talking about. They will not leave. I've directed them to leave tons and tons of times, so I just try to work with them in there. I get my bookcase and I place it, and I want to get books in the middle shelves, but I don't want to do the pillar glitch because all the walls are around and things. So I leave it and I go to do the kitchen, which also brings up some trouble, but I get it done in the end with a more messy vibe. Instead of having everything nice and lined up on the countertops, I use a messy vibe and I eventually turn this stove into a cooking station that actually works, and the refrigerator stays a refrigerator, but it swaps a bit. So this is where I'm figuring out it needs to be a bit messier, so I change it about and have it so it's not like aligned anymore, which I'm sure they won't have perfectly aligned everything. And I'm just trying to get like a sink or something in here, and I'm looking at, and I find a radiator, so I go and I put radiators through all of the thing and ignore my stillness there. The radiator in the bedroom is eventually destroyed, but I'm just looking for like a matte thing, but then I go back to books, and this is where I try to get books on the bookshelf, but it doesn't want to work. So after a long troublesome try, I go with clean sheets and towels. And remember, this is sped up, but this actually took me an hour, and when it stops, like when it goes cuts to the tour is when my video stopped recording, because it had reached the hour limit, because on PlayStation you can only record for an hour before your video clip saves. So I'm just looking for all the stuff here, and I find a nice stool that I use in the bedroom, which eventually, I don't want the floor to be all wood, so I try find a carpet, but I have to remove everything, including settlers, out the room, so that annoyed me a lot. But I'm working to try get, here my carpets and tiles, and they're not seeming to work. So I go back to floor coverings and I go to my textures and my square textures, and I moved all the furniture out the room, and I still couldn't get the settler to leave, so I moved all the furniture once again to make a clear path to the exit once I try with the settler in there, and they just don't seem to like this doorway thing, which I eventually get rid of and swap for a half wall. So I finally managed to get them out after a long struggle. I mean, go do your job. You're assigned to a job. So that really annoyed me that they weren't going to do their job and rather stay in the house that isn't even theirs, because I was going to assign this to a different settler. So, but they decided that this would be their house. So I have to put my half shack wall back on, and I'm struggling to get this. Alright, so I finally get it back on and I'm moving all this furniture back in, and eventually the bed and stuff does move place, but it's not too extreme. It's not like, oh my god, it moves like complete house or anything. The house shape stays pretty much the same. It's just the interior decorations that get changed when I reach the 60 minute mark, and I'm going here and I'm trying to assign them to their spot, but they just don't want to move. So this is where I get real angry. So I'm trying everything I possibly can just to get them to leave, and I realize it might be the door cap thingies. So I go and I get my stairs, because apparently they can't move without stairs, after I place in my new half walls, which I realize will work better. But this is where I move the bed, because you can't walk into a bed. But I've placed my half shack walls, and the settler is starting to cooperate a little better, but they're still not being good. So I add my stairs there, thinking, oh yeah, they'll go down, but they don't. So I have to add them to the side of the house, and then have them go out the side house exit. Also, at the side of the house, I do a lot of things, and I'm going to skip ahead here because this is kind of repetitive, and I'll see you at the tour.
to sleep in ships. It's making everyone a bit cranky.